Hello, good morning, and welcome everybody to Starbound yet again. We did something a little risky. As you can see in the background, there's a planet, and right below us is a moon. So basically, all I did was I was up here, I was decorating a little bit, and I was like, let me just sit down here in the captain's seat. So there's our home, and adjacent to it was the moon. Alpha Canoodle 5032 and Alpha Canoodle 5032A is the moon. So without jumping into the huge star map and going too crazy, because I don't know how fuel works and if I go out there, am I going to get stuck? Thank goodness there's the nice little go home button, so it can get you back to your base pretty easily unless you set a new home. We traveled to the moon. And we're gonna go check it out. Let's go check this out. I'm super excited. Wow. Did I mention I'm super excited? All right. So, like I said before, everybody. What is going on? What's going on? Oh my god, I'm dying. Whoa, what the hell? Who is this? Who are you? Oh. It's my stim merchant thing that I put down in here. If you saw on the wall, I put this, well, this thing. Don't take too many. What the hell? Okay, so this guy's just here with stims. Interesting. So I was on the planet. I was dying. Do I need a spacesuit for the moon? We're gonna go back down there. We're gonna try again. We're gonna dig ourselves underground and see if that stops us. Cause we're dying from cold. It was extremely cold. You know what? Screw it. I gotta. That's 400. Oh my god, that's a lot. You know what? I've already got some stims. Let's see what they do here. Let's see. Oh, my inventory's a mess. Where's the organized inventory button? My god. Where is it? And I want more bags, please. Because I just can't stand only two bags. There we go. What does the red sim pack do? Let's chat. Let's see what happens. Six. Yummy. Regeneration. Pretty cool. Okay. Let's kick the blue one here. We don't need... Well, we might need wood. Let's get rid of this. I was decorating, so I have a lot of stuff in my inventory currently. Because I pretty much broke down everything in our house, which I'm going to show you in a little bit. But it's still major work in progress. We need the back walls done and whatnot. And that requires me to go and actually, you know, dig up all the stuff that I want to put in the back. We got a lot of food, which is good. I have a bed. I guess I took my bed with me. Like I said, I broke everything down just to get here. Got another copper pickaxe, which we should probably take. And where's the other stim packs? The yellow stim packs. I believe the yellow ones radiate light from you. It could be heat. I couldn't tell you what it is, but let's, where are the bandages? I had them somewhere here. Bandages, where are you? My god, what a mess. What a bloody mess. Stuff everywhere. Oh, there they are. I got a ton of bandages. I got some food because I'm pretty sure I'm hungry. And for those of you who don't know, if you just hold alt, it'll show you, you know, how much food or how hungry you are. Which is always a bonus. So let's go ahead and char some of these bananas. Ooh, delicious. And let's use one of these. Glowing. All right, I'm glowing. Let's go back. Okay, so. Oh no, wrong button. Let's get in here before we freeze. My god, look at the temperature dropping. Oh my god, it's not stopping. Oh my god, it's not stopping. Oh, okay, okay. Oh my goodness. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I guess we are not going to the moon. That's fine, random. Alpha. Wow, there is a lot. There is a lot. How about this star? Alpha Lac. What does this say? Any information about it? Fuel. 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 Oh, there. Alpha Lac 1, Alpha Lac 2. It doesn't say what... Oh, level 4 threat. Level 4 threat. I don't know what level I'm equivalent to. Snow? No, we just... No. No, we just... yeah. We don't want to go to any more... Oh, there we go. This must be a warmer planet. It's closer to the sun. Can't land. Shh. Level 4, biome forest. Biome desert. Level 7. Oh, my God. Okay. Random. There we go. Threat level 1. Level 4. Desert. Hey, you know what? Oh, my God. 200 fuel. I don't have enough. Okay. I still have no idea where I am. Like, this is... Do I have an X on here stating exactly where I am? That might help a little bit. Can you zoom out? Ooh. Alpha. Everything's alpha. Level 7, level 8, level 3. Ah! Conquer. Just find random. Ah, God. Alright, fine. Let's go home. Check it out. It's such an awesome little thing. Like, the way it's, like, generating the world as you shooting into FTL. It's so sick. Really neat little idea. Get it all going, you know? Woo! So, yeah, this Stimpak merchant was in the last video that I posted, which was this laboratory that I found. Laboratory. And, yeah, there was a stim thing, and I didn't know. It says, place it whenever you need some stims. I placed it in here, and now this dude's just here. All of a sudden, this chicky with stims. I thought it was something that you place, like, all the time, and then someone will show up. But now, I wonder if this person will be in the ship all the time. I wonder. Or if it'll revert back to its teleportation state so I can place it somewhere else. You never know. You never know. So that cost me no fuel to go to the moon and back, which is good. I need to put more coal in here to give myself some more fuel to search the outlying planets, I guess. Okay. See, I could probably go here, because that's not too far away. Ooh, Jesus, threat level's huge. Okay, hold on, let's close that. Get off the seat. Get back in the seat. Find random. See, I say find random, and it doesn't stop me where I am, which is really stupid. Show me where I am first so I can see what's close, damn it. Okay. Alright, fine. I gotta find a way to work this out so I can actually see, take it to me. So I can see what's close. That's really dumb. Anyway, I guess we're going back to the planet. Whee! So as you can see, things are coming along much better. I've got my workstation down here with my two chests. I got my smelting and iron works over here with my other chest. This is going to be a neat little, I was messing around with wood backgrounds, windows and whatnot. It's really fun, really interesting to see. As you can see, I have a crap ton of of stuff growing. I got a barrel here because there's a merchant all the way to the right here, and they got killed by something, and So I just took their stuff. Waste not, why not. I see I need to fill in the background here with some sandstone. I started to make a laboratory up there. I need to get some more stuff for the background, and then we'll keep that going. Yeah, and this is going to be the main hall. I'm going to split it, and there's going to be two adjacent rooms up top. Obviously, maybe you'll split those as well. We'll do a whole bunch of stuff. It's going to be really, really neat. I've been messing around with staircases as well, just for fun. It looks cool. It's impractical in standards of the game. All I need to do is jump straight up, but I think it's cool anyway. So, that's what matters in the end, right? As long as it looks cool. So, yeah. That's all we've done. I guess we're going to cut this video shorter today because I was really hoping on exploring the moon. However, I guess we really need to, get better stuff. But yeah, as you can see, killing beasties right now is actually way easier. With the, the iron hunting bow. As soon as you guys make an iron hunting bow, strongly recommend it. It just makes everything, it makes hunting possible, you know, and then you can just get as much meat as you want. Plus, they also increase the drop rates for any melee weapons as well, which is good, because, you know, if you just really suck at the bow and you really just dislike it, which I don't blame you, because it's not that cool, then you can always, you know, still have a chance. Look at you covering his face. Come on. I got the hammer. It's really slow, but it's pretty much one hit. You know, one love, one hit. Oh, it's super slow, so you got to kind of time your hits better. Come on. Yeah, it doesn't really matter about that guy. So yeah, there's these poison pools here. I had to like put like blocks over them. I don't know if I can harvest poison. Like the poison and do something with it, make some kind of poison arrows or poison shard or something. That would be pretty cool. I didn't mean to kill the little friendly guy, but yeah, so I might actually put a whole bunch of coal into this little bird lady here. What up, bird lady? Sell me some cool stuff. She had a chest down here and I was looking for a button, like a lever to pull, because this looks like a secret door, but there was none, so I just went down here and I carved my way in there, and there was a chest, and it actually had some pretty decent stuff in it. So if you ever see the bird lady here, if she's in your game, you know, head in there. She's got some cool stuff. Maybe you can you can thieve it and see what happens. So you know what, I'm gonna go put more coal in our ship, and then we're gonna try and check out another planet. Actually, then I gotta do return trip too. Ugh. This could get messy. Let's see what I can add in here. Where's my coal? I got a decent amount of coal. You know what? We can go. Oh, whoops. Let's split that directly in half. That's a decent amount of fuel. That is a decent amount of fuel. But you know what? See you in the next video, everybody. I just wanted to see if I could do the planet. So now you know. If you try to go to the moon, pretty deadly. Probably need a spacesuit or some kind of heating blankets. A heating poncho, if you will. Otherwise, you might die. So until next time, everybody, stay tuned. And next time you see, we will be on another planet.